Hello, my name is Linda McAnany. I'm a very strong supporter of the United Way of Central Missouri. And welcome to Live United. My guest today is Jeff Bruker. Jeff is the Executive Director of Homemaker Health Care here in Jefferson City. Jeff, thanks for joining me, number one. And number two, it's good to see you. It's been a while.
Thank you, Linda. It's always great to be here. I always enjoy seeing you and getting a chance to tell the story of Homemaker Health Care.
And you do it very well. Jeff, a few weeks ago, and I think I mentioned this to you, a few weeks ago I got a call from a local pastor that was asking about respite care. And the thought occurred to me so many times, even though we talk about these agencies and your agencies on a regular basis, I'm not sure that everyone knows the extent of the services you provide, because you provide a tremendous number of services. So I thought it'd be a good chance to bring you on board, talk about the services, and kind of bring our audience up to date with your agency. So that said,
great. Thank you, Linda. Let's talk about
now you really have three classifications of services: in-home support, home health services, and private pay services.
Correct.
And by the way, I had to look at my notes to do that, but I didn't realize how extensive those services are.
We have a large organization. We have about 150 caregivers, and we service 18 counties here in Central Missouri. And if you're listening to this program or watching us today, then we are in your service area, or you're in our service area, I guess. Why don't we go ahead and start with the respite care, since you mentioned that one. Respite simply means relief. And what we do is, if you're out there taking care of a loved one, a husband, a wife, a child, you need a break. And you need a professional organization who has trained caregivers that are able to come in and work with your loved one, somebody that has medical experience, that has been trained in the proper techniques of taking care of the individual's needs, whatever they may be, whether it's Alzheimer's or Parkinson's or any type of medical condition. And then we have all those people on staff. That allows the caregiver to have the relief or the respite, similar to what you would expect, if you're taking care of your children all day. You do need to have, a break to get out to do shopping and things like that. A lot of times there are other family members that can do that, but, if you're in the situation, which is where most of our clients are, where, you're living with your spouse and that's the person that you're taking care of, then a lot of times there is nobody else.
Right. And whereas with a family or with children, you may be able to take them with you. That may not be the case with a loved one.
That's exactly right. Most of the time when you're caring for an adult, it's too difficult on you as well as on the person that you're caring for. To try and either get them out of bed or even out of the house if they're able to get up and use a wheelchair. It's still a very difficult situation. Right. And we also provide the transportation services as well, which would also assist with if you need to get to a medical appointment, or if you just want to get out of the house, do some shopping. If you're an individual that gets around pretty well but are no longer able to drive due to medical conditions, we'll come, send somebody, pick you up, take you to the grocery store, take you to the movies, whatever it is that you also want to do.
And in our community, that's a very important service because, let's face it, public transportation is limited to either buses, which don't run in all the time in the evening or after 5 o'clock, and of course cabs, which can be a little expensive.
They can, and our service differs from those primarily because we're available when you need us. We don't have a bus schedule, and we do have equipped equipment to be able to assist you in your transportation, where a lot of cab companies do not. It's also a program that is funded by our community with United Way's assistance. If you do have a financial need, we will review that. Take a look at your current conditions and situations and see if we can assist wherever we can.
Sure.
The service that we provide all ties together into one cohesive company. We also provide assistance with homemaker chores, which or your laundry services, because you find a lot of times people can continue living at home, but it's tough to keep up with the activities of daily living. Matter of fact, Linda, I have trouble keeping up with my own activities of daily living.
Absolutely. and we're in relatively good shape. One of us is really in good shape. You know, you bring up a good point with regards to those in-home care kind. Sometimes it's simply a matter of one thing that allows someone to continue to live in their home.
That's right.
And the financial difference between perhaps having to move into an assisted facility versus staying in home is tremendous, is it not?
It is. It costs about three times more to take care of somebody in a residential setting than it does in their own homes.
Wow. Unbelievable. Now, you do have some, I'm going to use my words, nursing kind of services as well, do you not?
We start off with as simple things as assisting with cooking, cleaning, bathing, all the way up to skilled nursing, physical therapists, occupational therapists, whatever the individual needs in the home. We work up a care plan that's tailored to their needs. When we have the trained staff on hand and available to provide that.
Now, who does the assessment? Do you have people who specifically go out to the home and say, okay, let's see what you can do, what you can't do, what you need and what you don't need?
That's a great question. You know, being in the industry, a lot of times we overlook the obvious on that, but that's exactly what we do. People will simply call our office at Homemaker Health Care, and we will send an individual out. It's one of our county coordinators who will sit down with you, find out what you're looking for, and also may provide ideas to the individual that they may not have even considered before. We got a call from an individual the other day, and her mother was coming down to stay with her for a couple of weeks. And of course, her mom's house has already been set up where she lives to help with her adaptations and needs, such as the grab bars in your shower or an elevated toilet that makes it easier to sit down and get up off of a commode. And when we were visiting with her, she hadn't thought about a lot of those things. She knew it was going to be a problem, but something as simple as picking up one of those shower handles that can come off, and you can, you know, get a bench that sits in your shower so you don't have to stand for long periods of time.
Those handles, by the way, are great. I'm seeing those more and more in hotels, motels, et cetera, because they are so easy to use and move around.
You know, it's funny. I think that's probably one of the biggest requests that we have when we have questions is how do you get a hold of, those items? Mm-hmm. Where can you get them? And we can assist with all of that. Right. And talking about special adaptive equipment, that's probably going to be one of your questions, Linda.
I am. We're going to save that. I know what you're going to, because we do need to talk about that. Now, you have, and this is relatively new. I think I remember when this came on board, maybe 3 or 4 years ago, what's called private pay services. Explain that.
Private pay is where I would say 90% of what we do, and which is why we are here, is to assist people that are on Medicare, on Medicaid, and there is a population of individuals that are out there for whatever reason that don't qualify for one program or the other. They may not be, old enough to qualify for Medicare.
Right.
They may have, an asset base that's not going to allow them to qualify for Medicaid. And they require services as well. And, what do you do in that case? For example, if I needed an assistance, maybe I was in an accident, broke both my legs, was set up for a little while, there would be very difficult for me to get around. And what do you do in a case like that? Well, we also provide our services to individuals on a private pay basis that can hire, our organization just like you would any other service. And we are a not-for-profit organization, and any money that we do make, we turn around, put back into the company, back into our employees, back into our community through services such as what we're talking about here today.
Right. I just thought that was such an interesting concept, because in many cases, as you say, perhaps someone has an accident, they're too young to qualify for Medicare, and they make quote too much to qualify for Medicaid, and yet they need the services. You know, they may need some meal preparation or help with moving around or whatever. So I thought that was that was a great opportunity, not only to help the community, but also to make some additional dollars for you all.
Well, and one of the things that, you know, is so important for our organization, and, you know, that we always let people know, you can find people that will assist you. You can call around, you can, you know, hire a friend of a neighbor's
right.
cousin, but you never know who those individuals are.
Right.
Homemaker Health Care spends a significant amount of time and money background screening all of our employees. We do a full criminal background check. We do drug testing. And not only do we do that before we hire them, we continually do that during their employment with us to make sure that the people that we're hiring are going to be able to take care of somebody that's in a position that they may not be able to look out for themselves.
Right.
So that's, you know, that's a very important piece to what Homemaker Healthcare does, is make sure we find the right employee to put into the homes of a loved one.
Other than private pay, are there fees? First of all, who are most of your clients?
Most of the clients are either Medicare or Medicaid, and those are both state and federal programs.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a fee schedule that is set by both of those organizations, and that's
so you
that's
could you could basically during that assessment within the home, working with the client or a loved one of a client, mm-hmm. you could basically not only tell them what services are provided, but what the cost is going to be, if any.
That's right.
That's great.
That's right. And all they need to do is call Homemaker Healthcare. It's no cost to have somebody come out and visit with you, find out, are they old enough to qualify for Medicare? What are their income levels? Are they a veteran, possibly?
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of programs that are out there and available. And it's funny because a lot of times we have gone out and done an assessment at the home and simply made a few recommendations to how they could adapt their home to the individual, and they necessarily didn't need our service right away. You know, one individual was really getting frustrated because she was having such a hard time assisting her spouse simply out of bed in the morning.
Right.
And so we came out, actually had a physical therapist take a look at the situation, make a few recommendations, and the transfer from the bed into the wheelchair
made it much easier.
Made it much easier.
Oh, absolutely. We're going to take a break right now. When we come back, I want to talk a little bit about the fact that, unfortunately, our population is aging, and that gives you some additional, not only opportunities, but challenges. And then we want to talk a little bit about how we can help you with additional employees. I know that's always an
great
issue.
Great, thank you.
Hope you'll stay with us. We'll be right back.
Say Merry Christmas. Did you have a good Christmas? Yeah. You get lots of stuff? Yay! Get your horsey. Do something cute. You're just gonna sit there and grin?
If you don't stop your friend from driving drunk, who will? Do whatever it takes.
In America, you are not required to offer food to the hungry or shelter to the homeless. There is no ordinance forcing you to visit the lonely or comfort the infirm. In fact, nowhere in the Constitution does it say you have to provide anything for anybody. Thank you for all you've given. Imagine what more could do.
Welcome back, and thanks for staying with us. My guest today is Jeff Bruker. Jeff is the Executive Director of Homemaker Health Care here in Jefferson City. And when I say here in Jefferson City, your offices are here, but you cover, as you said earlier, what, 17 or 18
counties? 18 counties.
18 counties, so you spread yourself a little thin. Jeff, we were talking just before the break about the aging population and the fact that that population bulge, baby boomers are reaching retirement age. What challenges does that provide you?
The biggest challenge that the entire healthcare industry is facing is how are we going to handle this large number of seniors coming through the system? And ironically, the industry that we happen to be in, Homemaker Healthcare is an in-home services provider, is one of the answers to that. And obviously, hospitals aren't going to just build, more hospitals just to take care of a boom of seniors coming through the system. They'll be able to treat who they need to treat, but then they'll be discharged, either to another facility or back to home. And it's funny because this industry is really starting just to come into its own. When you think about it, nobody wants to be anywhere other than home. That's
right.
That's where we want to be as long as possible. But the big thing is, as long as it's safe. Mm-hmm. And that's what Homemaker Healthcare does. When we do our assessments, we come in to make sure that the situation that the individual is in is going to be safe for them, as well as the other individuals that are living in the household. And that can be done for just about anybody that's out there.
One way that you're doing that, and I don't want to spend a lot of time because we have so much to cover, but telemonitoring. Describe that to our audience.
The way the technology moves, it wouldn't be long before healthcare you were able to, receive, an upgrade into your home and your life. And what this telemonitor does is it's just the exact same thing that you get when you sit down at one of the pharmacies, you put your arm in the blood pressure cuff, but it's a home unit. Mm-hmm. Sits right on a tabletop, takes your blood pressure, checks your pulse, checks your oxygen saturation in your blood. All of that information is relayed electronically back to our office where a nurse monitors this 24 hours a day. And if an individual has some sort of a condition, we're able to see it a lot of times even before
they know themselves.
Right. And that's why the doctor's offices take your blood pressure, take your weights. And this unit that's a home model does all of that for
that's
you.
That's great. And then keeps it on a record and can provide that record to the physician.
To your physicians.
That just brings up, that was one way of being able to reduce, provide services, but to do it with one less person.
That's right.
And I know that's a continuing problem for you. It's finding, you mentioned earlier, you're very specific about the requirements you have for your employees. But obviously, you have ongoing needs as this population and this client base expands. Talk about that a little bit.
That's a great question. Even in this market with unemployment at the levels that it's at, we still struggle to find quality employees who are dedicated to this line of work. It's hard work. Mm-hmm. You think, cooking, cleaning, but it's the compassionate side of you, and you hear about this from teachers and people that are in the service industry that are always giving and giving and giving of themselves. It takes a special individual to be able to do that, and we are always looking for those individuals. So if you're one of those people that just think, wow, I'm somebody that loves to take care of people, loves to have animals, has the big heart, this is the perfect job for you. And the greatest thing about this job, Linda, is it's flexible. The hours that we provide, that's where we get all of our employees. Usually are from individuals that are looking to stay at home with the kids and maybe work at 9 o'clock. They need to be off by 3 o'clock. We can accommodate that schedule. Or they want to pick up some extra income from a full-time job someplace else. We have clients that need to have supper 7 o'clock at night.
Right.
That's when they want to eat. So 3 or 4 hours a week, they'll bring in that time, as well as we have a lot of people that just donate their time because they want to be able to give back to the community because they've had something happen in their life and they've received assistance. So we do have volunteer positions as well.
And you provide benefits. Do you
not? We do. We have a fairly decent benefit program. We have all of the major holidays that full-time employees receive, as well as insurance that's available, sick leave. So yeah, if somebody's interested in a job, they'll meet our requirements, able to pass the background checks, and are looking for a caring career, then call Homemaker Health Care.
That's good. You know, funding is always an issue with any United Way agency. And I say that based upon the fact that it's not like there's a steady revenue stream, particularly if there are federal dollars and state dollars involved, because
that's
the
right.
Budgets change from, I know you and I had a conversation not too long ago talking about those state dollars. Where are you on this right now? Where is the agency?
Well, we rely on both the state and the federal programs for funding. And when I say we rely on it, the individuals are the ones that qualify for the programs.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like anybody else's budget. The state and federal government has budgets, and they have to live with inside those budgets. And as we talked about earlier, as the senior population grows, you know, they are going to require more care. The more care
right.
requires more money. And where does that money come from? That's the question. And you know, there's really not an answer for that yet. As the system moves through, then we will start to see how it plays out. But right now, funding is a concern on agencies like Homemaker Healthcare.
Ongoing basis. Obviously, you also require ongoing funding from agencies like the United Way.
We do.
And how is that money spent?
You know, United Way money is spent with Homemaker Healthcare. We don't turn away a client no matter what their ability to pay is. And that's usually the biggest differentiation between Homemaker Healthcare and other organizations
right.
that are similar to what we do. If somebody needs service and they're outside of the normal driving, well,
mm-hmm.
we have a lot of those. You know, we have clients that may take 20 or 30 minutes just to drive to. That's expensive, but we don't look at costs. We look at their need
right.
And their level of care that they're going to
require.
You
know, and particularly with gasoline prices as of today, and this is a tape, as of today, $3.59, I think, a gallon, those costs are no small
that's
amounts.
Right.
So glad to hear that. You also depend on the generosity of others.
We do.
And not only giving of money, but also time. What are some of the duties your volunteers do?
The number one duty that our volunteers usually undertake is visits. They'll go to somebody's home, provide some relief for a family member to get out, as well as transportation. Friendships is a big one. You know, if somebody needs to go to a doctor's office, it's very difficult for them to call on a family member or a neighbor that has a full work schedule. Can you take me to the doctor's office? Well, we've all had appointments that, you know, took a little longer than
right.
what we thought.
Right.
And so our volunteers are, you know, designed for that. They have a 4 or 5 hour block of time that they wish to donate. We'll set them up with a assist on a visit, whether it's to a doctor's office or maybe a shopping or even going to a movie with somebody. That's a very valuable need, and we never have enough volunteers, Linda.
Yeah, and I think just the fact of a caring volunteer perhaps spending some time, we talked about respite, but spending some time, quality time with someone is so important.
That's right. And, you know, the friendship is really the biggest thing on that. You know, somebody that has spent their entire life working in our community, and all of a sudden now they're in a situation where it's difficult for them to get out of their house. It's tough to make friends.
Absolutely. You know, the one thing that I always like to talk about when we get together is the equipment needs, because I think that's such a wonderful program. Tell the audience about the equipment opportunities.
This is a great program, Linda, and there again, this is another program thanks to United Way. What we do is collect walkers, wheelchairs, bedside commodes that individual families have that they no longer need. They can donate those to Homemaker Healthcare. We'll give them a tax receipt. So they can write those off on their taxes instead of throwing them away. A lot of times people don't know what to do with these items. We clean them up. We sterilize, sanitize them. We take a look at them, make sure that they're in sound condition. If they need repairs, we repair those, and then we make them back available to the community as a program. We have lots of doctor's offices, we have lots of social workers, priests, parishes, will all send referrals over to Homemaker Health Care. You know, the situation usually is immediate need, because somebody mm-hmm. finds themselves in a situation where all of a sudden they've had a fall or something traumatic happened in their life, and now, you know, how am I going to take care of my loved one?
Right.
Didn't used to have to do that. Now I don't know what I'm going to do. They don't have that equipment available. So it works several different ways. One is we provide the equipment on an emergency basis. If you find yourself in that situation and you need something right away and you don't know what to do, you can call Homemaker Healthcare. We'll get it out there, and that'll give you, you know, a week, 2 weeks to go out and find what you're looking for. Or even if money's a little bit tight, gives you a little bit of time to save up the money to go buy your own. If you have a dire financial need, we work with you on these programs. This is a no-cost program to low-income individuals and seniors. Also, if there's that equipment laying around in your basement, call Homemaker Healthcare. That's
you don't have to put it in a rummage sale.
You don't have to put it in a rummage sale.
And speaking of rummage sale, I think your staff is wonderful. I love this idea. You all have a rummage sale every year, don't you?
We do, in the fall. The date has not been set yet, but if you've got items laying around your house and you'd love to donate those to a charity or not-for-profit, Homemaker Healthcare will take those items. And what we do with them is we hold a big rummage sale in the fall, and all the money that we make off of that rummage sale, a quarter at a time, a dollar at a time, all goes into either purchasing equipment that we don't have in our equipment loaner program, you know, providing the transportation to individuals that are homebound, and just many, many services, Linda.
Yeah, that's great. Listen, before we close, if they want to contact you, the telephone number is
635-3900.
That's easy. And also, you have a website. It's a very good website, www.homemakerhealth.org. A lot of good information on there. Jeff, thanks for joining me. It's always good to chat with you. You're doing an outstanding job. You're just a lot of fun to be around.
Thank you.
And you're doing a wonderful thing for the community, so thank you. Before we wrap up, I want to recognize and thank one of our United Way agency longtime directors. Ben Smith just retired recently from ABLE, Adult Basic Literacy Education. And I wanted to thank Ben for everything he's done and also recognize him in the community. Great, great guy with a lot of, has helped ABLE tremendously. And with that, this is it. Another segment of Live United is under our belt. We'll look forward to seeing you next time. Good night and God bless you. Mm-hmm.